like to call up is the Honourable Linda Reid, who is the Speaker of our Legislative Assembly in Victoria, and please give her a warm welcome.
Good evening, all. Let me say what a pleasure it is to be here. I was absolutely charmed to have the welcome extended to me by Janet. And some of the words I live by: we all have a responsibility, in my view, an obligation to brighten the light where we stand. I do my absolute best to instill that in my children. I have a 12-year-old son and a 16-year-old daughter. And the notion that the years move ever so quickly, I can still feel the weight of my daughter as I placed her in my arms when she was born. And 16 years has elapsed. I can tell you that as a parent, you're often a peacemaker. My son will say with his hands on his hips, "How long will my sister be annoying?" Well, perhaps the same length of time you might be annoying her. I can tell you a very fun story. My little boy was sitting there watching the Legislative Assembly on the television with my husband. And he says to his father, "Mom was really mad at the big boys today." And my husband says, "How do you know that?" He goes, "Oh, Dad, I know that look." I was a teacher prior to being elected. And every once in a while, that look does come in handy. We want, in Victoria, we want very much to arrive at better solutions, closer and closer approximations. I'm always delighted that we actually work towards resolving some of those differences. Because at the end of the day, all of us want a more civil society. No matter where you sit in the Legislative Assembly, that is what all of us wish for. Is the path to that similar? Some days as diametrically opposed as possible. People come at it from an array of different vantage points, an array of different angles. But at the end of the day, we try and coalesce around doing something that actually is helpful, is actually improving some circumstance. One of the programs that speaks to me, goes all the way back to my teaching days, is the Roots of Empathy. I don't know if you know the program. It was founded by Mary Gordon, a kindergarten teacher from Newfoundland a long time ago. But its mandate is to create a civilized society one child at a time. And what the research has found as they track this program over not just many provinces in Canada, but many countries in the globe today, was that it actually does reduce the incidences of bullying in classrooms, on playgrounds, in communities, because children are taught to understand the vulnerability of a little tiny babe. A brand new baby will visit a classroom at least once, if not twice each month, from the time it's 2 or 3 months old to the time that little boy or girl is a year of age and they celebrate the birthday. Because lots of children today are single children. They don't have siblings. They don't have those experiences. And as they watch that little person develop but understand how fragile an 8, 9, 10-pound baby is, what happens on playgrounds, those children who are in Roots of Empathy programs, they see a disturbance on a playground, they will actually intervene. And it just, as an educator, as a policymaker, it warms my heart. Because that's what we want for all children. That's what we want for every community. People to say, this is the benchmark. This is the behavior we're looking for. And we're not going to accept anyone harming anyone else. And if you can instill that in very young children, you have made an inroad that they will remember their entire lives. I say the beauty of the Roots of Empathy program for me is not just the interactions that happen on playgrounds, but I truly believe it will change how those youngsters parent their own children one day. And that's really, really effective succession planning. That's what you want. You want that sense of cherishing every human being instilled in their souls. So when they become parents, they have some of those opportunities as well. Those are my thoughts for this evening. Thank you so very much on behalf of the province for allowing me to come.